Hey guys and gals, this is Trevor with the Young Entrepreneur Society and of course TrevorMock.com, coming at you with another a purpose-driven entrepreneurs book club announcement. So we've got a new book for this next 30 days right now. It's nearing April, so this book is going to be our April book club for 2014. And one book I'm going to show you, this might be one of our books here in the future. It hasn't been a book club book yet, but I read it this past month and it made a huge, huge impact in my business. So we were already starting to do some of this stuff, but it really ramped it up. Guys, other than this book club, go get this book. It's called The Pumpkin Plan by Mike Michalowicz. I'm actually interviewing Mike in April on The Pumpkin Plan. And it's basically a way that you can go through and simplify your business, make more, you know, earn more profit, spend less time working, more time off, stuff like that. But it's really powerful. When you read the first 16 pages alone, you'll get, I mean, it'll blow your mind the things you need to change in your business. But before I announce this next book, I've got a friend, Kevin, actually. Kevin, if you're watching this, it was his birthday yesterday, and he's down in Disneyland. So this book this month, I'm just going to flash it really quick. It's about Walt Disney. But before I show you that book, this is from a snippet in Oregon Business Magazine. And they have the What I'm Reading in here. And one of the owners, one of the guys in here, an entrepreneur from here in Oregon, owns a company called Dutch Bros. So it's a coffee company. They kind of pioneered really making the drive-through coffee experience just epic. And their company does over $100 million a year selling coffee through drive-through, which is insane. So his two favorite books are ones that I've read. I love them. Think and Grow Rich, that's a requirement for everyone, in my opinion. And Unlimited Power by Tony Robbins. I've never read that one, so that might be one on the list here shortly. But this month, guys, go buy this book on Amazon. The link is below. It is How to Be Like Walt, Capturing the Disney Magic Every Day of Your Life. And this isn't just about business, okay, guys? This is about how to live, how to really, what's like they're saying, how to really capture the magic of a guy like Walt Disney in your everyday life. How do you really bring out the creativity? How do you really bring out the fun, the playfulness, the mission? How do you build that stuff into your business? Fun, playfulness, mission, creativity, a bunch of other things. And that's what we're reading. So it's not a short book. It's a thick book. But I really enjoy stories of entrepreneurs like this that I admire. And Walt Disney is one of the guys. I look at that and I go, man, what he did in his life was huge. Number one, he did things that everyone told him couldn't be done. He invented a new category of business, which was this type of theme park. And he went into places that was in the middle of nowhere and created huge attractions that attract tens of millions of people across the world to these, all from an idea, all from this creative idea. How do we capture that? That's going to be in this book this month, guys, so buy it. If you didn't read last month's book, I don't have it here in front of me, but check the book club video archives down below. And guys and gals, let's make 2014 a big year for you, both life and business, okay? Part of that happening really is education, is bettering yourself, is reading stories of other entrepreneurs like Walt Disney, like Mike Michalowicz with the Pumpkin Plan, and other people even around you in your local area, to get inspired by them. Find out what's working for those people, what's not working, so you're not making those same mistakes yourself, okay? And sometimes we have to make those mistakes, but at least reading these books gives us quick outs or quick ways around those mistakes, hopefully, before we make them or immediately after we make them, we notice that we made them. But if you have any suggestions on some really, really great books that you guys want to read this year, put them in the commentary below. We've already picked out the next three or four. And what we're going to start doing, just so you know, is in the past several years, there's been a few books that I go, you know what, this book we need to read every year. Okay, this book really helps reset the mindset. This is one that everyone needs to read every year. There's several books like that. Here's one of them. Here's one of them right here. This is one that we read, one of the first books we read in the book club, The Five Major Pieces to Life Puzzle by Jim Rohn. And it's a really simple, short book. It's only like 120 pages long, but it's one of the most powerful books that I've ever read. And this one, here you can see my book. I've got it dog-eared everywhere, all over the place. Okay, those are my notes on it. And this book is one of my annual reads now. This one right here, it's like rather than fitting in a new book, I need to read this one because this one's got everything that we need to reset our mindset to be a success every single year. So what we're going to start doing, guys, in the book club is about half of the books are going to be brand new. So about 6 books a year are going to be brand new that we've never read in the book club, like this one right here. And about 6 books, it might be a little less, are going to be ones that we have read, but they're ones that we're rereading because they're so important to us to really get that message in our lives every year, like this one right here. Okay, and there's another couple of them. So it might be that ratio might not be exactly right. It might be 3 books that we read every year and 9 that we read that are new, or it might be 4, 8, doesn't matter. Okay, in the end, we're going to start reading. We're going to start rereading some books every single year because they're so powerful. We need to get that message in our life all the time and then introduce new stories like this. So go get this month's book club. Watch out for the email that announces when we're going to be doing the call. And please, guys, show up for the darn call. Okay, block out that time in your schedule because you wouldn't believe how much power it is discussing the book with other people, and also the accountability, okay? Because for me, I know that I have to be on this call to discuss this book, so I get the book read. That's my accountability. If you don't have any accountability for yourself, even if it's reading a book, it's going to be really, really, really tough to achieve your goals. So please make the time to show up for our book club calls. If you need further advance, hit up Jen, my assistant, and she can actually get you in advance of when our call is going to be, a month in advance if we need to. But how to be like Walt, capturing the Disney magic every day of your life. Get it. Let's hop in this month and read it. Thanks, guys.